Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sam and this video is about uterus ultrasound reporting. We will only see the reporting of uterus. Other organs are not included. We will only focus on the findings and impression of uterine pathologies. This report is of a normal uterus. You can start by writing this line. Ultrasound examination of the uterus was performed using a transabdominal or transvaginal approach or both. After that, you can write the position of the uterus, whether it is antiverted or retroverted or antiflexed or retroflexed. Then you can talk about its shape, size, and contour. Then you can write the measurements of the uterus and finally mention the presence or absence of any mass. Then you can mention the endometrial thickness and write the appearance of the endometrium. In this example, it is homogeneous. And in the end, you can write no intrauterine gestational sac or evidence of fluid collection is seen. After that, you can write about the appearance of the cervix and mention its length. And in the end, you can write about any cervical stenosis or mass. In this normal example, there was no evidence of cervical stenosis or mass. Now we will look at reporting for pathologies. The first case is of endometritis. You can start by writing how the ultrasound was performed, whether it was transvaginal or transabdominal. Then you can talk about the size of the uterus. In endometritis, it can be enlarged with thickened endometrium, with increased endometrial thickness. In this report, it is 12 millimeters, which is consistent with endometritis. There is also a diffuse heterogeneous appearance of the endometrium with increased vascularity noted on color Doppler. After that, you can write no gestational sac is seen in the endometrial cavity and there is no evidence of free fluid or abscess formation in the pelvis. And in the end, you can write about the appearance of the cervix. In the impression, you can write ultrasound findings are consistent with endometritis with an enlarged uterus, thickened and heterogeneous endometrium, and increased vascularity. Then you can mention the presence or absence of gestational sac, free fluid or abscess formation. And in the end, you must write clinical correlation is suggested and further evaluation with lab tests and or other imaging may be warranted. This line is important because a diagnosis is not completely done on ultrasound alone. Now we will look at endometrial fluid collection. The clinical indications can be postmenopausal bleeding, suspected endometrial hyperplasia or cancer, pelvic pain or discomfort. These indications are non-specific as many pathologies have the same indications. In the findings, you can start by writing about the approach. Then you can write the endometrial stripe is visualized and appears thickened. Then you can write the measurement followed by this line. There is also the presence of hypoechoic fluid collection within the endometrial cavity measuring 2 cm in diameter. In this example, it was 2 cm. You can end the findings section by writing about the gestational sac and the appearance of the cervix. In the impression, you can mention the presence of endometrial fluid collection, and then you can mention the endometrial thickness, followed by mentioning hypoechoic fluid collection and its measurement. You can also write the history in the impression, and then you can write this line: raise concern for endometrial hyperplasia or endometrial cancer. And after that, you can mention further evaluation with endometrial biopsy and or imaging may be warranted to rule out malignancy. This report is for endometrial polyp. The clinical indication can be postmenopausal bleeding, abnormal uterine bleeding, pelvic pain, and discomfort. In the findings, you can write the approach, the endometrial stripe appearance and its thickness, and then you can write there is a focal echogenic non-shadowing lesion and its measurement within the endometrial cavity consistent with an endometrial polyp. If there are multiple lesions, you can write here there are multiple echogenic non-shadowing lesions and write their measurements, or you can just write the measurement of the largest lesion. In the impression, you can write the findings are consistent with the presence of an endometrial polyp. Then you can write its measurement and its location, that is within the endometrial cavity. After that, you can write the measurement of the endometrium, followed by mentioning the history of the patient or the clinical indication. And then you can write the concern for hyperplasia or cancer. And in the end, you can write about clinical correlation. This is an example report of endometrial hyperplasia. After writing the approach, you can write the measurement of the endometrium, and then you can write about the echotexture of the endometrium, whether it is heterogeneous or homogeneous. In the impression, you can mention endometrial hyperplasia as evidenced by diffuse endometrial thickening. Then you can write the measurement and then the appearance of the endometrial echotexture. And in the end, you can write about clinical correlation. Next is the report for a suspected endometrial carcinoma. There is usually a focal, irregular, heterogeneous lesion in the endometrial cavity. So first you can write the approach, followed by mentioning the appearance of the endometrium and its thickness. And then you can write about the heterogeneous irregular mass seen and also mention its size. And in the end, you can write suspicious for endometrial carcinoma. In the impression, you can write findings are consistent with the presence of a suspicious endometrial lesion, followed by its size, and then you can write suspicious for endometrial carcinoma. In this example, the thickened endometrial stripe of 20 mm in the setting of postmenopausal bleeding raises concern for endometrial cancer. And in the end, you can write about clinical correlation. Now we will look at reports for fibroids, starting with intramural fibroid, in which the fibroid grows within the myometrium. The clinical indications can be pelvic pain and heavy menstrual bleeding. In the findings, you can start by writing the approach. Then you can mention the position of the uterus, whether it is antiverted or retroverted. Then you can write its measurement. After that, you can write the features of fibroid. In this example, there is a well-defined hypoechoic lesion measuring 4 into 3 into 4 centimeters, located within the uterine wall, suggestive of an intramural fibroid. In the impression, you can write, findings are consistent with the presence of an intramural fibroid, followed by the size of the fibroid, and then its location. And in the end, you can write about the history and clinical correlation. This is a report for subserosal fibroid. The clinical indication is pelvic pain. For subserosal fibroid, in the findings, you must write a well-defined hypoechoic lesion located on the outer surface of the uterus, suggestive of a subserosal fibroid. This is the impression. You can mention the subserosal fibroid and its size, followed by its location. And in the end, you can write about the patient's history, further management, and clinical correlation. Our next case is submucosal fibroid. The clinical indication is abnormal uterine bleeding. After imaging a submucosal fibroid, in the findings, you must write, there is a well-defined hypoechoic lesion located within the endometrial cavity, suggestive of submucosal fibroid. In the impression, you can write, ultrasound findings are consistent with the presence of a submucosal fibroid located within the endometrial cavity. Also mention its size. The fibroid is likely the cause of the patient's abnormal uterine bleeding. Here is a report of pedunculated fibroid. The clinical indication was pelvic pain and pressure. The findings for pedunculated fibroid include a well-defined hypoechoic lesion located on a thin stalk protruding from the fundus of the uterus, suggestive of pedunculated fibroid. These are the findings in this example. In the impression, you can mention the presence of a pedunculated fibroid, followed by its measurement, and also write about the stalk and its location. And after that, you can write, the fibroid is likely the cause of patient's pelvic pain and pressure. This report is of lipoleiomyoma. The indication was routine pelvic exam. In the findings, you can write, a well-defined hyperechoic lesion with areas of fat attenuation. Then you can write its size, followed by its location. These are the features you can write in the findings. In the impression, you can write, the findings are consistent with the presence of a lipoleiomyoma, followed by its size and its location. And after that, you can write about the clinical indications. And then you can write about clinical correlation. Our next case is adenomyosis. The clinical indication in this example was pelvic pain and heavy menstrual bleeding. In the findings, you can write the uterus is enlarged and the myometrium is diffusely thickened and heterogeneous with multiple small cystic areas. In the impression, you can write the findings. The myometrium is diffusely thickened and heterogeneous with multiple small cystic areas, suggesting the presence of ectopic endometrial tissue. Then you can write adenomyosis is likely the cause of the patient's pelvic pain and heavy menstrual bleeding. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and stay tuned for more imaging videos.